Happy Sunday. I'm Chelsea from thestudentarchitect.com, which is an online space with resources for architects and architecture students. If you're sick of trying to learn Revit through YouTube videos, then I highly recommend checking out my Foundations of Revit course over at thestudentarchitect.com/classes. Today we're going to talk about wall bounding properties. So right now we're looking at a bathroom plan, and currently there are technically three different rooms within this bathroom. So there is the bathroom itself, there's the shower, and there is the water closet. So if I hop into the room tool, RM on the keyboard, you can see we have one room, another room, and then another room. So if you would prefer to create a room with all of these spaces in one, then I will show you how to do that. I will say it can be helpful if you're creating ceilings and want to have separate ceilings for each of these types of spaces. We'll go into CE on the keyboard to hop into the ceiling tool. It can be useful to have bounding walls for these purposes. So we can add in our ceilings here. And then if we change our mind later on and decide that we want to create a room with all of these spaces or maybe some of these spaces, then I'll show you how to do that too. So let's say maybe we just want the bathroom and the water closet to be one room, but then we want the shower to be its own space. All you need to do is select on one of these walls here and unselect room bounding in the properties panel. And now when I go to RM on the keyboard for room, it's combining both of these spaces in one, but it's still excluding the shower. So if I solidify that room here, you can see the boundaries of that room, and it's giving us the area of this space. And then if I add in another room here, then it's giving us the area of the shower as well. Now, if you wanted the area of the entire space, let's delete this room. But remember, that's not deleting the actual room from the project. We would have to create a room schedule to do that. Now, if we wanted to include the shower space now, then we would just need to unbound these walls as well. So I'll unselect room bounding, or we can deselect all of these walls to get the total area of this space. And then you'll see that number change. And now it's giving us wall-to-wall area of this bathroom space. If at any time you change your mind, you can always rebound those walls. And you'll see that area change. We can create another room here so that you have that area. And then you're all set. I really hope that you found this video helpful, and if you did, please hit that like button, and if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe. It really helps out my channel, and it lets YouTube know that you like videos like this, and they'll give you more of them. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next Sunday.